the judge. Jude, verse 14. See, the Lord is coming again at the end of time with thousands upon thousands of his holy ones to judge everyone and to convict all the ungodly of all the ungodly acts they have done in the ungodly way and the harsh words ungodly sinners have spoken against him. These men are grumblers and fault finders. They follow their own evil desires. They boast about themselves and flatter others for their own advantage. In the last times, there will be scoffers who will follow their own ungodly desires. These men are the ones who divide you, who follow mere natural instincts and do not have the spirit of spirit. James 4:11, brothers, everyone. Do not slander one another. Anyone who speaks against his brother, anyone or judges him, speaks against the law and judges it. When you judge a law, you are not keeping it, but sitting in judgment on it. There is only one lawgiver and judge, Jesus Christ. The one who is able to save, give eternal life with him, and destroy, which is hell, death forever. But you who are, you to judge your neighbor, which is anyone, James 5. The Lord's coming. The Lord's coming is near. The judge, Jesus Christ, is standing at the door. Amen.
visit, so. Okay, now. And the wind's coming to go, so excuse me there as well. And this week someone's called the judge. I think I had one something like this a while back, but. To depict all the ungodly, ungodly acts they have done in the ungodly, ungodly way, and the harsh words ungodly sinners have spoken against him, These men are grumblers and fault finders. They follow their own evil desires. They boast about themselves and flatter others for their own advantage. In the last times, there will be scoffers who will follow their own ungodly desires. These men are the ones who divide you, who follow mere natural instincts and do not have the Spirit, the Holy Spirit. James 4:11, brothers, everyone, do not slander one another. Anyone who speaks against his brother, which is anyone, or judges him, speaks against the law and judges it. When you judge the law, you are not keeping it, but sitting on judgment on it. There is only one lawgiver and judge, that's Jesus Christ. The one who is able to save, give eternal life with him in his kingdom, live forever, and destroy in hell, death forever. But you, who are you to judge your neighbor, which is anyone? James 5. The Lord's coming is near. The judge, Jesus Christ, is standing at the door. Amen, amen. Excuse me for the noise. I'm next to the highway. Like I said, they rearranged the benches and stuff, so excuse me. I don't think it's supposed to rain today. The sun's playing hide and seek today, so. Okay, now this week's Sean's lesson is darkness and light. At the beginning, God, our Heavenly Father, created everything, including us in Genesis 1. There was nothing, just darkness everywhere. Then He, God, created everything, including us, provides life for us, and the only way towards eternal life with Him and His kingdom. When He comes again at the end of time, there'll be darkness again, and He will be the light. He'll be the light again. We will be drawn to Him. When He comes on clouds with His holy angels, He will judge us on who or what we love and serve as our God, on where we will land between life with Him. On His new holy city, where He'll provide for us again, where there is His light, love, peace, joy forever, or death, darkness forever. So remember that. Amen, amen. Okay, now let's pray. Be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our trespasses. Forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not to temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory from never. Amen. Now remember, I've been teaching you in Matthew 6:19. Do not you will build for me? Where will my resting place be? Has not my hand made all things, made all things, made all things? And so they came to being, declares the Lord. This is the one I esteem. He who is humble and contrite in spirit and troubled at my word. But whoever sacrifices a bull is like one who kills a lion, and whoever offers a lamb, like one who breaks the dog's neck. Excuse me. Whoever makes a grain offering is like one who presents dog blood. To the moment of birth, he had delivered, says, Lord, do I come? kill and covet, but you cannot have what you want. You grow and fight. You do not have because you cannot ask. God, when you ask, you do not receive, because you ask with wrong motives, that you may spend or get what you get on your pleasures, you adulterous people. You adulterous people, don't you know that friendship with the world is hatred towards God or Heavenly Father? Father, excuse me. I was going to say something else too. Anyone who chooses to be a friend of the world becomes an enemy of God. Or do you think Scripture says without reason that spirit, he comes to live in us in peace and peacefully. But he gives us more grace, that is why Scripture says God oppressed the proud. But gives grace to the humble. Submit yourself then to God, resist the devil, and he will flee from you. Come near to God, and he will come near to you. Wash your hands, you sinners, and purify your heart, you double-minded. Grieve, mourn, and wail. Change your laughter to mourning and your joy to gloom. Humble yourself before the Lord, and he will lift you up. Brothers, which is anyone. Do not slander anyone. Anyone who speaks against his brother, which is anyone, or judges him, speaks against the law and judges it. When you judge the law, you are not keeping it, proceed in judgment on it. There is only one lawgiver, one lawgiver. And judge the one who is able to save, Jesus Christ. Restore life with him. And destroy life, which is hell. But you, who are you to judge your neighbor, which is anyone? Excuse me. Now listen, you say, today or tomorrow, we will go to this or that city, spend a year there, carry on business, and make money. Why do you not even know what will happen tomorrow? What is your life? What is your life? You are a mist. That appears for a little while and then vanishes. Instead, you ought to say, if it is the Lord's will, we will live and do this or that. As it is, you boast and brag. All such boasting is evil. Anyone then who knows the good he ought to do, and does do it, sins. Amen, amen. John, 1 John 2:15. Do not love the world or anything or anyone in the world. Use them as God. If anyone loves the world, the love of the Father in heaven is not in him. For everything in the world, the cravings of sinful man, the last LUST of his eyes, and the boast of what he has and does comes not from the Father in heaven, but from the world. The world and its desires will pass away, dying in hell. But the man that does the will of God is forever with him in his kingdom. Amen, amen. So remember that. Okay. Jude. That sun would stay out, wouldn't be so bad. Jude, a servant of Jesus Christ and the brother James, to those who have been called, who are led by God the Father, and kept by Jesus Christ, mercy and peace and love be yours in abundance. Dear friends, although I was very eager to write to you about the salvation we share, I felt I had to write and urge you to contend for the faith they make. Doubtless, once all entrusted to the saints which are righteous, for a certain man whose condemnation was read about long ago and secretly. Excuse me. Slipped among you. They are godless men. Who change the grace of our God into lessons for immorality, and deny Jesus Christ, our sovereign Lord. Though you already know all this, I want to remind you that the Lord delivers his people out of Egypt. Delivered his people out of Egypt, our forefathers, from Pharaoh's slavery, but later Take care of your personal man, your spouse, and children. Number 3, get to work for a few hours a week. to thank people for your prayers and caring for my mother who has terminal cancer. Thank you. God bless you for it. Now pray for Bogota, Colombia, floodwaters, an avalanche in a small city. Killed at least 200 people and 200 injured with families and victims in Texas. A man was driving a taxi that killed 12 people in a crash for the families and victims. In London, a terror attack from 2 weeks ago killed 4 and injured 40 for the families and victims. Excuse me, loud to man. In Illinois and surrounding areas, tornadoes from a few weeks ago for the victims. My mom, Gertrude, she has terminal cancer. Dan, Pastor Dice, Jerry, David, they have health problems. John, Heather, Jesse, Robin, Anthony, Donald, his 21, 22-year-old daughters, they are going through something personal. Our President, Louis, over State City, pray for each other, pray for you all, for my health organizations, and all of them. Peace, joy, and righteousness of God be with you all. Excuse me. My mom wants us to go back to Missouri, near Kansas City, Missouri, on Memorial Day weekend for another visit. I told her we'd try. It's a 5 to 6 hour drive one way. We took the main highways through St. Louis and Columbia, Missouri. It's faster anyway. It's in God's hands. Me and my oldest son took turns driving. My mom's dying of terminal cancer. It hit me when I saw her last weekend, so I've been crying a lot. She's not only my mom, she's also my friend. Anyway, thank you. God bless you. I'm going to make this fast. Start towards the old man. Wow, stop. Hey, I was here.
Let's go!